lady by the name of Hannah in Fort Wayne, Indiana, has a question. Can someone be possessed and not know it? Also, can being possessed cause someone to not have a moral compass or a conscience? Let's start out by saying that possession is a word. It can mean a lot of things. It depends on your theological perspective or your experience. But most people who have demons don't know they have demons. They think they have a problem. They may have an urge, a compulsion to do something that's against their personal moral code. And they wonder why they desire that thing or why they have certain thoughts. Sometimes I have good Christian people say to me, I came to you because I have a wonderful life serving the Lord, but ever so often I have these thoughts of killing myself. I've even had people say, I'm a solid Christian, and yet horrible sexually perverted things have come into my mind. I'm wondering, is that from a demon? Well, if there is a craving of some kind that you can't control, and you've tried everything, it could be a demon. Particularly if it is so egregious to how you normally would conduct your life. A lot of people who come to my seminars and manifest demons, and you see them on our YouTube channel, had no idea when they came to the seminar that they had demons. They're in complete shock when the demon manifests itself or they feel the demon starting to rack inside. So the majority of the people who have demons don't know that they have demons. And part of the problem is that the preachers have told them that Christians can't have demons. So when they have these bad things happening to them or these strange or supernatural things happening, they automatically try to explain it away because they're a Christian and can't have a demon, so therefore it can't be a demon. And about this issue of a moral compass, yes, demons can deprive a person of the acuity of understanding the moral component of their actions in life, particularly if the issue is generational. So if you've inherited a demon, it can affect your moral compass, so to speak. But in many cases, there are people who have demons, but they have such a strong moral compass or belief system, the demons can't get them to do what the demons want them to do. I sometimes have the demons say to me, I'm trying to get this person to do such and such, and they just won't do it. They pray all the time. They spend too much time in the Word of God, and I can't make them do what I want them to do. So see, you can have a demon and not necessarily be acting out demonic behavior. Well, the point is you need to get rid of that thing so that it isn't still lodged there waiting for a time, like a landmine, to go off if you step on it the wrong way. Everybody needs deliverance. Everybody needs to be demon-free. And that's why we have our International School of Exorcism and the Advanced Academy. That's why I've written all the books that I have, to give you the materials, the education, the training, to understand all of this, what true demonic possession is, how demons operate, how they hide, how they can influence you in subtle ways that you may not think are demonic. So just because you don't think that you have a demon doesn't mean you don't have a demon. Everybody needs to go through inner healing and deliverance. Everybody needs to have those kinds of prayers to be certain nothing is hiding. I encourage you to get help through this ministry, whether it's through meeting with me personally in an encounter session or having a Skype session or getting in touch with one of our deliverance teams around the country to be sure that you know you don't have any demons and that you are truly free indeed. The International School of Exorcism, an online Bible college of spiritual warfare. The history of exorcism, healing, deliverance, and spiritual warfare. The practical aspects of breaking curses, pulling down spiritual strongholds, and removing the legal rights of Satan. Set yourself, your friends, and family free by enrolling in the International School of Exorcism. In our new book, Set Your Family Free, we teach how to raise children with purity principles, how to prepare them for adulthood, and how to break every assignment of Satan over their lives.
We give you the principles of spiritual warfare to fight for your family and to be victorious over the powers of darkness.
This is the book that will set your family free. How do you know if your problems are the result of bad life choices or demons? My 200-page book, Dealing with Demons, has answers for questions most are afraid to ask. Can Christians be demon-possessed? How can I know what's natural and what's supernatural? Dealing with Demons will teach you how to recognize symptoms that the devil is at work in your life. Be one step closer to living in spiritual victory. The most frequent demon that I deal with is the spirit of Jezebel. This demon wants to destroy your health, your finances, your marriage, your family, and your church. My book, Jezebel, is your key to overcoming the most prevalent evil spirit of our age. Get your copy today.
He took the curses away from me. Was he Bob Larson? Because he can help you.
If your life isn't all that it should be, if relationships aren't working, if your health, your finances, or your spiritual life are unhappy, schedule a personal one-on-one encounter with me. We'll get to the root of the issues that are holding you back. We'll give you answers and a whole new direction in life.
Oh, what a change, what a difference when you have an encounter with God.
Take action. I look forward to seeing you soon.
Encourage your support for this worldwide outreach to do what Jesus did. For the latest information on resources, seminars, conferences, training institutes, retreats, and international missions, go to boblarson.org. Thank you for your prayers and financial partnership.